My name is MaryClare Rollins, and we're at Montana State University in the Department of Microbiology and Immunology. I work in the Wiedenheft Lab. In our lab, we study the interactions between viruses and bacteria. Bacteria are infected by viruses just like animals are infected by viruses. We study how bacteria respond to being infected by viruses. They have their own defense systems that they can use to ward off those infections. So by studying these bacterial defense systems, we can learn something about the fundamentals of the biology that's happening when organisms are infected by viruses. I'm originally from Detroit, grew up there, left when I was 18 to come out here to Montana to go to college. And I don't come from a traditional science background. Neither of my parents were scientists. My mother is a teacher and my father was an engineer. I guess I was always a how and why person. I wanted to know how things work and why things work, and I wasn't always satisfied with the answers that I got. Science, on top of being an investigation of really fantastic mechanisms of life, Cas 3 plus Cas 1, right?
Love it.
Yeah. A scientist has the opportunity to get answers to her own questions. One summer, I volunteered for a project in Glacier National Park, and we were using hair traps to collect hair from grizzly bears. And then we could use those hair samples to get specific DNA from individual bears. And I really loved the intersection of the ecology and using DNA to track individuals in a population. Short term, of course, I work in what's called basic science. So that means that we want to answer unanswered questions about fundamentals. So there's a biological process happening and we don't understand how it works. So on the one hand, a large driver for me, for my work, is to figure out how things are functioning. What's the mechanism? And then on the other hand, that kind of work is really useful for helping us build the next generation of biotech tools. So the kind of work that we're doing right now, studying these bacterial defense systems, has already led to a huge explosion in biotechnological tools that can help us do things like treat HIV. I think the days of the lonely scientist are gone. You need to have a crew of great, sharp, hardworking people to get anything done. So we're fortunate enough here. This group here is fabulous. Lots of smart people, and we all work together really well, and that's why we're able to be productive. Science has been one of the major drivers of civilization for as long as there's been civilization, right? We came out of the cave and we looked over the hill and we went to the next thing. That's part of the brilliance of doing science. And if we want to talk specifically about biological science, then of course there are obvious applications like medicine. It's important for people's quality of life. We need to be learning today how to fight the challenges that we'll have tomorrow. There are still plenty of disease states that we can be working to improve people's health.